No decision yet on a proposal to redefine the meaning of full COVID vaccination in the Philippines. The health department continues to discuss the recommendation with the COVID Interagency Task Force. Their proposal is to redefine the term fully vaccinated to include booster dose in a bid to raise the uptake of the additional jab.
Sa ngayon, status quo tayo. Kung ano po yung first and second dose nyo, you are considered fully vaccinated. Pero kapag na-redefine po ang definition ng fully vaccinated, it would include one booster dose. So ibig sabihin yung third dose po ang kasama dyan.
Health Undersecretary Maria Rosario Vergere asserts the redefinition would affect many protocols, including the alert level system. She says areas under Alert Level 1 could be escalated to Alert Level 2. For the Health Department, instead of redefining fully vaccinated, it's better to label the vaccination status of boosted individuals as up to date to avoid confusion.
Overseas, a Florida judge has overturned the U.S. government's mask mandate in public transport. The judge called it unlawful, saying U.S. officials exceeded their authority. The lawsuit was filed last year by a group challenging state and federal vaccine and mask mandates across the country. The decision comes just days after the Biden administration extended by 15 days the mandate requiring individuals to wear masks on planes, trains, and other public transport.
So this is obviously a disappointing decision. The CDC continues recommending wearing a mask in public transit. As you know, this just came out this afternoon. So right now, the Department of Homeland Security, who would be implementing, and the CDC are reviewing the decision. And of course, the Department of Justice would make any determinations about litigation.
So in the U.S., health officials overhaul the national COVID travel risk assessment system. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention unveiled its new system Monday. The updated classification rules out a do not travel warning and reserves it only for special circumstances. Most European countries are under the level 3 category, indicating high risk for COVID infection. The Philippines, meanwhile, is now at the CDC's lowest classification. This as new COVID infections in Manila continue to decline.